Hi, I'm Dr. Jennifer Wan from Ardent Vision Eyecare in Richmond Hill, Ontario. In today's video, I'm going to lay out what I believe is the new roadmap of options for vision care for the nearsighted child or young adult in the 21st century. What are the options available to the nearsighted individual? And what are the considerations in deciding which path to take? Let's dive in. We know that myopia, or nearsightedness, is a common vision problem that often begins between the ages of 6 and 14. It affects up to 5% of preschoolers, about 9% of school-aged children, and nearly 30% of adolescents. Decades ago, the old roadmap for the nearsighted person looked something like this. They might find out that they need glasses as a young kid, and their only other option is to try wearing contacts too if they want to when they're a bit older. Fast forward a few decades, with a few significant research and technology breakthroughs, the new roadmap now offers one more option for the nearsighted child. Nearsightedness might still be discovered at a young age, but we can start myopia control at the same time we correct the child's vision. That is, use methods and interventions to slow the progression of nearsightedness. This can be achieved with specialty contact lenses, glasses, or in conjunction with eye drops. I talked about the different methods of myopia control in other videos on my channel, which I'll link in the description box below for you. The higher upfront cost of myopia control as compared to traditional glasses or contact lenses is about the only downside of this new option. In fact, it might save the child and the parents money in the long run if the child does not have to pay a premium for high prescription lenses for every pair of glasses they'll get in the future. More importantly, myopia control will slow the stretching of the eye, thereby decreasing the chance of sight-threatening eye conditions such as retinal detachment, glaucoma, or myopic maculopathy. In other words, if one has the financial means, it is in the best interest of the child to be enrolled in a myopia control program when nearsightedness is found at a tender age. Whether one opts for myopia control or not, the glasses prescription tends to stabilize in one's late teens or early 20s. In the old roadmap, one would expect to wear glasses or contacts to correct their vision thereafter. Again, the new roadmap offers an alternative here. Instead of expecting to wear glasses or contacts for the peak years of productivity between age 20 to 40, the myope has the option of proceeding with one of several vision correction procedures, including LASIK, PRK, SMILE, or ICL. Given that progression of myopia was controlled, the treatment required will not be as significant. While I say this is a newer option, the technology has really been around for 30 years now and has been performed on some 40 million people worldwide. LASIK, the most common vision correction procedure, is known to have the highest patient satisfaction rate of any elective procedure worldwide. That speaks volumes in itself. Some of the most common concerns regarding vision correction surgery is regarding the high cost of the procedure and the potential of vision loss due to complication. Let's evaluate the different options based on three practical aspects: functional, safety, and financial. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I don't think anyone would want to rely on prosthetics to see clearly if they don't have to. Imagine how much more convenient it would be to go about a day without having to worry about glasses sliding down the nose, fogging up, or contact lenses drying up and falling out. Vision correction procedures allow for just that. Truly correction-free clear vision. Did you know that serious infections that lead to blindness happen to one of every 500 contact lens users in America? Compare that to the chance of an infection due to a vision correction procedure, which is estimated at 1 in 1,000. It may take some of us aback that according to the statistics, vision correction procedures is a safer module for achieving long-term glasses-free clear vision than contact lenses. The actual numbers may vary from case to case, But the average annual cost of wearing eyeglasses in America is $450. The annual cost of wearing contact lenses is averaging $900. Let's run some calculations together. With these annual expenses, one would have spent $9,000 on eyeglasses or $18,000 on contact lenses between the ages of 20 to 40. The average cost of a vision correction procedure is a one-time cost of $5,000. It is a high price tag up front, but could end up saving the individual money in the long run. And there you have it, the complete roadmap for the nearsighted person from birth to age 40. Which path would you choose for yourself or for your children? If you would like to learn more about each of these options and would like to consult me as an optometrist in the Greater Toronto Area, feel free to book an appointment with me with the website below. Did you learn something new in today's video? If you did, please press the like button to show your support. Consider subscribing for more free eye health videos. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Bye!